Hello, everybody. My name is Ivan Pedersen. I am one of the two singers of the Danish pop duo Laban. And I understand that we enjoy some success, especially in South America. Lautaro have asked me to talk a little bit about myself, a little bit about Laban, and a little bit about our career.
¿Cómo están, amigos de YouTube? Volvemos con un nuevo video y una nueva entrevista en el canal. En esta oportunidad vamos a entrevistar a Ivan Pedersen del grupo danés Laban, un grupo formidable del Eurodisco de la década de los 80 con éxitos como Cowboy Surprise y Love in Siberia. Él nos va a estar respondiendo todas las preguntas que le enviamos con respecto a la creación de Love in Siberia, cómo fue la disolución del grupo a fines de los 80s y mucho, mucho más. Así que si te gusta la música de los 80s y el Eurodisco, esta entrevista no te la podés perder. Hey, ¿cómo están? Justo estaba entrando al canal de YouTube. Te recuerdo que este video tiene subtítulos en español. Actívalos, tienen que estar en la parte de la doble C o en los tres puntitos. Y de paso, si no estás suscrito al canal, puedes hacerlo en este momento. Y activa la campanita, así no te perdés ninguno de los videos que vamos a estar subiendo a futuro. ¡Vamos con el video!
And the formation of Laban was a coincidence, really. Our musical producer had found a song in Italy and it had been a hit all over Europe. He just didn't understand why it wasn't a hit in Scandinavia. It just wasn't. So he asked me, why don't we try to make it in Danish? Make a Danish lyric for it and see what happens. And then I happened to write some actually quite innocent words that were a little naughty in the 80s in this lyric, and it became hugely popular, and this song sort of really exploded. The original Italian title was Sarà perché ti amo, and the Danish lyric translated into English was, where are we going to sleep tonight? And that seemed to affect a lot of people, and the single got hugely popular. After that, we decided to see if we could follow up on that success. So we made a very fast we made an album, our first album. And on the day that it was released, we had a gold record presented. And that was in the days where gold record meant quite another number of sales than it does nowadays. So we had a flying start. And so the idea of shaping the group was actually fostered in the mind of a record producer. And Lisa and I looked in each other's eyes and then we said, let's go for this. You've tried all the things you have, and I have tried all the things I have. Let's try and move together on this one. So we went in 110%, gave our all, and we were working very, very hard. Albums. Laban have had three albums in Denmark. That was hugely successful. Of course, we started to think maybe we got something that would interest other people than people in Denmark. So we started to translate our stuff into English, or writing new English lyrics to the songs that we recorded. And fantastic how the English sound changed our sound, really. Because when we started to sing in English, we sort of really fell into that sound. The sound of the time. Although that the two of us at the time when Laban started actually were a couple of grown people, we just snipped into that sound at the time. We found another song in Italy called we wrote an English lyric to it called "Caught by Surprise." I've forgotten the name, the title in Italian. I've forgotten. We called it "Caught by Surprise," and we released it in Danish first in our own country, and it sounded really good. And it, that song really suited our voices, and that was the first door opener to the international market. Our record producer said, "We need to have a song that can do the same for us as Self Control have done for Laura Branigan." I guess you know that title. If you're interested in this kind of music, you know definitely Self Control. And when you hear that, you can understand that "Love in Siberia" that we wrote after that was very inspired by Self Control. But we found our sound that when we started singing English and making English lyrics, we found the sound that was breaking our way into the American chart with "Love in Siberia." And after having done that, you know, being in the English or in the American chart, every door sort of opens for you. But, Laban existed for 7-8 years, and we were working very hard and played all over Europe, making television shows and recording new stuff all the time, doing a lot of live gigs, And there comes a time when you are sort of worn out. The time after 4 years, having been working really, really hard for 4 years, we were sort of approaching the end of it, and we could feel, both of us could feel it, that that we were getting close to being worn out. And then we entered the American chart, Billboard Hot 100, with "Love in Siberia," and then you get totally re-energized and say, "Oh wait, maybe we should give it another go." And we decided to give it everything we had, see if we could follow up on that. But you know, as it happens a lot of times, working very hard on new material, we just didn't succeed in making a song that made the same impression on the American market as "Love in Siberia" did. So one album after "Love in Siberia" and one single and one last tour, we decided that we have exploited the Laban idea, the Laban construction, to the end of it. So we agreed to finish our pop duo in 1988 and haven't recorded together since. Leisha on her own, I have recorded lots of stuff, also lots of stuff that she wrote herself, sort of in the light jazz era, and I myself have moved more into rock and roll and singer-songwriter stuff, where, you know, the man and his guitar. So and I've actually had some nice successes since then, but neither of us have had success the size of the one we had in Laban, because that was, when it was biggest, it was an explosion, and it really took over all our lives. Yeah, like any other person, I have doubts and regrets from old days that I know more about now. I would be able to come through crisis much easier with the knowledge I have now. For instance, there are a lot of contracts I wouldn't have signed today. I definitely changed the wording of them anyway. And but I've had a musical journey through my life. And I've touched and worked with so many genres that actually I'm really a spoiled brat. I'm a lucky man. And I've had different successes with different genres. One huge one with Laban, and the rest of it is you know, I live a fine life with the music I do, I make now, and I am, like in any year, I'm totally in love with what I do. So I'm very satisfied at the time, but I'm not known outside of my own country. It was nearly happening with Laban because of that chart positioning in America. We ended up being released in 41 countries. And it was all a matter of finding the number two single after Love in Siberia. But we never found one that was really ready to make it. So that's how it goes in pop music, you know. There are one-hit wonders all over. No, I don't think so. My tastes in popular music have changed. I myself is at another place, sort of. I have new interests and I listen to new another stuff. I don't listen to so much to the pop genre that you dance around to in Argentina. That some people dance to in Argentina. Anyway, in any time and any decade and any year, there are good songs and bad songs, good productions and bad productions, but it doesn't matter really, because the songs that stand after time, the songs that people love, the songs that people carry around with them, take them with through their life, it's very different, and there are audiences to all kinds of songs. Of course, within each genre there are really horrible recordings and really good recordings, but who can decide what's good and bad for whom other than yourself? I mean, there are songs I hate, there are songs I love from every decade, and I guess you have it exactly the same way. I'd like to send my regards to all you youngsters in Argentina and Brazil. I know there are a lot of people in Brazil too, and I would actually like one day to go to Argentina and see one of your great huge parties where 800 people are dancing around to one of the songs is one I've made. Of course, that would make me proud to stand there looking at you dancing away. So until then, until I get that ticket for Argentina, until I get it bought, I hope you have a lot of parties, a lot of things going on. And I hope that you listen to more than Eurodisco. I guess you do. But of course, it's great party music. Good regards to you all here from Denmark in the north, on the other side of the globe. And maybe we meet someday. Until then, bye-bye.
Espero que te haya gustado el video. La verdad que para mí, Laban fue un grupo de los 80s que aún sigue sonando y lleva la bandera del Eurodisco vigente. Son grandes las canciones que han producido, no solamente en su álbum famoso The Caught by Surprise, con esos dos singles que te mencioné al principio del video, sino también el resto de las canciones que estuvieron haciendo antes de ser conocidos mundialmente, y el después, con discos como Roulette, un disco que tiene mucha calidad de sonido. Si no lo escuchaste, te invito a que lo escuches. Un álbum fantástico. Déjame en comentarios qué te pareció el video, dale like si te gustó. Compartí conmigo qué canciones te gustan de ellos, qué parte te gustó de la entrevista y demás. Sin más nada que decir, nos vemos en el próximo video y un saludo grande a todos los fans de la música de los 80s y 90s. Chau, chau. Pero igual si querés andar ya, yo de periodista, así que...
Sí, no, por eso te digo.
Se ve bien, ¿no?
Uh-huh.
Bueno. Acomodate y...
¿Qué? ¿Cómo? No te preocupes, me voy a poner...
¡Ay!